Okay, so you're continuing along with a side project in Rails and it's going great. That's fantastic. But before you see that angel investment round, you're gonna have to solve some technical problems with your application. And one problem that I've seen needs to be solved on all Rails apps is asynchronous tasks. But before you provision a Redis instance and install the Sidekick gem, check this out. By using our current database infrastructure and without any extra dependencies, we can have recurring asynchronous job queuing and processing in Rails. This is all done through solid queue by default in Rails. Solid queue is amazing, and we're going to implement it in our application right here. So let's get into it. Solid queue is a part of the solid trifecta group of libraries that are new by default in Rails 8. Solid queue enables you, the developer, to handle all of your asynchronous job queuing without any extra dependencies like Redis. And by dropping a dependency, you drop the complexity of your application. And by moving on from Redis and RAM cache storage, you can drop the overall cost of running your application. So let's get into configuring solid queue for our application in development. It's really fun. Okay, so we have an application here that we've been working on. Actually, we've been building this throughout this whole entire series on Rails 8 called Rails 8 Unpacked. If you want to check out some of the previous episodes, go ahead and do that now. But this is the application that we've been working on for a little while. And this application is a task management app. Users can log in, they can see all their tasks, they can work on them, they can chat on them. Actually, this messaging feature was built in our last episode using Solid Cable, and it came out pretty great. So if you want to check that out, you should. Now, a user, when managing these tasks, can push them into the completed state. Now, if I click update, this task was completed. I can now go back to my tasks and I can see that I have a task in my completed state. Now, all this functionality is really great, but what happens when a user completes a lot of tasks over a long period of time? Is their completed list just going to grow exponentially for all time? Well, no, we don't want that. So let's build in our application a task archiver job so that every once in a while we will archive a user's completed tasks. Then in the future, we can build a special view where a user can see their archived tasks and do whatever they want with them. Now, creating a new job in Rails 8 is as easy as it's ever been. It's pretty straightforward. We can just run bin Rails generate job, and we want to call this the task archiver job. Okay, now we can open up our application and go into our task archiver job. And just to start with, in this job, we can do the most straightforward thing. Okay, so let's just grab all of our tasks where our status is completed. And we want to update all of these tasks to the status of archived. Now, this works because if we go to our model task, we can see that we have different statuses, and these statuses include archived and completed. So these statuses exist in the schema for these tasks. We can find all the tasks that status is currently completed and update them all to archived. And in theory, what's going to happen here is if we go to our task index page, the user will see only their in progress and completed tasks. So when we update a task to the status of archived, they will no longer see that task. And we can just delete args here because we don't have any arguments in this job. Okay, so now that we've created our job, let's configure our Rails application to use solid queue in our development environment so that we can play around with it. So let's go into our config database.yaml, and we can see in our database.yaml file, we already have entries under development for our databases. We have a primary database, which is the Postgres database that we set up by default in this environment. And we also have two more. Now, these are both part of the solid trifecta. We have solid cache and solid cable. These are the databases we set up for cache and cable. We can see here that our cache key holds a database and our cable key also has a different database. Both of these are in SQLite. And in a previous episode, we created this SQLite anchor in our YAML file to use down below. So let's set up our queue database for solid queue. Now we can copy this section right here in our YAML and paste it below. And we just want to rename cable to queue. And our database is not going to be named Life Task Planner Development Cable. It will be named Life Task Planner Development Queue. And our migrations paths also have to be changed to Queue Migrate from Cable Migrate. And that is essentially the configuration for our database for Solid Queue. And the last piece of configuration here is we need to configure our development environment to use Solid Queue as the queue adapter. So let's go into our config development.rb file. And we can actually, believe it or not, take a queue, pun intended, from our production environment because production already has solid queue set up in Rails 8 by default. So we can actually copy these two pieces of configuration in our production RB file, and over in our development RB file, we can paste them down here. And these two pieces of configuration basically just say we want our active job queue adapter to be solid queue, and we want the database for solid queue to be queue, which is the database that we configured over here. This name on line 37 matches the name all the way at the end of line 32 right here. This is the database we are writing to for solid queue, and this is the database that we configured in database.yaml for solid queue as well. Okay, so now all we have to do is quit our app, run bin rails db migrate, and our schema should be copied, and now we should have our SQLite solid queue database all set up. So now if we want to, we can actually just run our job using our Rails console. We can open up bin rails c and start typing our archiver job. And we can see that we can tab complete to task archive job, and we can type perform later. And if we hit enter, we can see it is inserting into solid queue a new job that is going to be picked up and run by solid queue. So already we have solid queue working in our development environment. However, if we go to our application and we hit refresh, we can see that this completed task has not been moved to archived. And I know that because I can still see it on the page. So what we have to do now is actually run bin jobs. And what bin jobs will do is it'll run solid queue. Solid queue should see this job in its queue that we just enqueued in our Rails console. And then if we now go back to our application and hit refresh, we can see, yes, this completed task is now in the archived state. And so just for sake of sanity, what we're gonna do here is edit our procfile.dev, which is what I use to start my development server. And I'm gonna add a new entry here for jobs, which has been jobs. And then so now whenever I start my development server, I usually run bin dev. This will run my web, my jobs, and my CSS all in one. So now I'll never forget to run my jobs executable. So this is great and all. We can run our job ad hoc, but if we want to archive people's completed tasks in a timely fashion, we're going to want some way to run these jobs all the time at some kind of interval. Well, thankfully, Solid Queue implements a scheduler process that allows you to create recurring jobs. And what we can do is we can open up our recurring.yaml file to do exactly that. Now, the recurring YAML file is amazing. It's super easy to understand. In our development environment, what we want to do is create a new recurring job, and we want something like, we can call this periodic cleanup because that's essentially what our new task is doing. And what we want to do is we want to run a class, and this class is going to be the task archiver job that we created earlier. Let me just make sure that is the job that we actually did create. Yes, that is the name of the job. Good. I just had to reference that just to make sure. And the queue that we want this job to take place in, we can call it the background. That works for me. And there's no args that we want for this job because there are no arguments, but the args key is what you would use for any of the args you want to pass by default to your job that you want to run in a recurring fashion. And for us, for the schedule, now this is actually very interesting. You see, Rails uses the fugit gem under the hood to parse the dates in your recurring.yaml file, which makes it amazing to read. It's super easy to read things that are parsed with fugit. You could actually use just plain language to describe how quickly you want this job to run, and fugit just figures it out. So for us, just for testing purposes, let's run this job every 30 seconds. Super easy to configure. That's it. Now we have our job that will be enqueued in a recurring fashion every 30 seconds. So now every 30 seconds, everyone's completed tasks are going to be archived. Now, of course, this isn't something you would do in production. We're just showing this off for testing, but this is essentially how you would do it, and it's super easy to configure. So now the scheduler process should run this job every 30 seconds. And if we look in our application here, let's create a new task. Actually, let's just mark this task right here as completed. And then in 30 seconds or so, it should disappear entirely from our screen. Okay, and there we go. Our tasks disappeared entirely from our screen because the job ran, and now this task is in an archived state. Awesome. Isn't it great when things just work, especially on a demo like this? It makes me feel good. Okay, so now we have our job, we have solid queue running, and we even have a recurring YAML file set up to run our job every 30 seconds, and everything runs through solid queue, and it's awesome. But how do we get insight into seeing how our jobs are actually doing? Well, there's an already existing solution called Mission Control Jobs. Mission Control Jobs is a lightweight front end to the active job adapters, and it currently supports rescue and solid queue. So let's install Mission Control Jobs and see how everything's working. To start, we can go to our gem file and we can add mission control jobs. Let's go below Puma right here. That seems like a good place. Now we can run bundle, and great, all of our gems are installed, so mission control jobs should be installed now. And it says in our routes file, we want to mount the mission control jobs engine, and jobs is a good endpoint for us, so let's do the exact same thing that they have in the docs. So let's mount mission control jobs at jobs. Cool. So let's restart our server and then go back to our application. Let's log out and go to the jobs endpoint. And oh no, it looks like our authentication is clashing with mission control jobs. Well, you see, this is actually a good thing because we don't want any old person who's logged in to be able to see mission control jobs. This is an admin piece of functionality. So how do we handle that? Well, if we look at the documentation in mission control jobs, we can see that there's a way to specify the base controller for your class. Now, by default, it uses application controller, but as you remember in a previous episode, we set up authentication for our application controller. So our application controller is actually implementing authentication for users, and we don't want that in mission control. We want to make a new admin controller. So let's do that right now. From the command line, you can just do bin rails generate controller, and we can call this admin. And there we go. It's as simple as that. And now if we go to our admin controller, instead of having an admin controller inherit from application controller, because if you remember, application controller is implementing our authentication, what we actually want is for our admin controller to just inherit from action controller base. So now it's not inheriting the authentication that we put into our application controller. And in this admin controller, we could do something like HTTP basic authentication, and we should have environment variables, but just for now, we're going to hard code a name as admin. And the password is going to be password. And for those of you watching right now, don't steal this password. I'm going to production with this thing, so don't narc on me, okay? And now that we have our admin controller created, we can configure mission control jobs to actually use admin controller as its base controller, as opposed to the default, which is application controller. Now, the most practical way to do that is with our application.rb file. We have an example right here in the repository. So let's copy that and go back to our application. We can go to config application.rb, and somewhere in this block, we can just paste this configuration, and we can set mission control jobs base controller class to admin controller. So now that everything is configured and I've restarted my server, if I go back to my application and go to localhost 3000/jobs, I should be presented with, yes, basic authentication. And if you remember, we set this as admin for the username and password for the password. Once again, don't steal it. And then we sign in, and here we are. We have mission control jobs. We can click on all the instances of task archiver job and see all the options that were passed to it and everything else. And of course, we can see now we have 29 finished jobs. We're running this thing every 30 seconds. So in the time it took me to configure everything, restart our server, it has run 29 times now. That's pretty cool. So by taking our job queuing infrastructure off of Redis, we can reduce yet another dependency and potentially another bill from our platform as a service provider. We also reduce our complexity in the application overall. I think solid queue is a fantastic approach for queuing your asynchronous tasks in Rails, helping you get from hello world to IPO with as little friction as possible. Solid queue is amazing. You should definitely check it out. And hey, thanks, nerds.